Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. Photoshop has a great new feature that lets you save your adjustment layers as a preset, so you can quickly apply them to other images. You can even export and import your presets, so you can save them to your computer or share them with other Photoshop users. To use this feature, make sure you're running the latest version of Photoshop. You'll need version 25.5.0, released in February 2024, or something newer. I'll start with this image, and to show you how presets work, I'm going to add two adjustment layers to create a bleach bypass effect, which is often used in movies to give them a high contrast and low saturation look. In the Layers panel, I'll add my first adjustment layer by clicking the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon, and I'll choose Brightness Contrast. The adjustment layer is added above my image. When you save a preset, Photoshop will include the settings in the Properties panel, as well as the blend mode of the adjustment, and even the layer opacity. But all I need to do here to create the high contrast look is change the blend mode of the adjustment layer to Soft Light. And Soft Light works by darkening the shadows and brightening the highlights to give the image higher contrast. It also increased the color saturation, but we'll fix that next. I'll add my second adjustment layer by again clicking the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon, and this time I'll choose Hue Saturation. In the Properties panel, I'll lower the saturation value to -40 to fade the color. And back in the Layers panel, I'll change the blend mode of the layer to Color. So the adjustment affects only the color in the image, not the brightness. And we have our quick and easy bleach bypass effect. To save the adjustment layers as a preset, we first need to select them. So since my hue saturation adjustment is already selected, I'll hold the Shift key on my keyboard and click on the brightness contrast adjustment to select them both. Then to save the preset, go up to the Adjustments panel. And you'll find a new section called Your Presets. It's directly below the main adjustment presets that Adobe added back in 2023, and I have a separate video on how to use them. If you're not seeing any of the presets and Photoshop is up to date, click the Adjustments panel menu icon and make sure it's set to Modern View, not Classic View. Then to save the preset, click the plus icon. Give your preset a name, I'll name it Bleach Bypass, and then click Save. The preset appears under Your Presets, and Photoshop uses your image to create a thumbnail for the preset. So now that the preset is saved, I'll switch over to a different image. And our preset is still listed in the Adjustments panel. If you hover over the preset, you'll see a preview of how it will look with your image. And then just click on the preset to apply it. In the Layers panel, notice that the preset was added as a layer group, with the preset's name as the name of the group. And inside the group are the adjustment layers, along with your custom settings. So by saving them as a preset, I was able to quickly apply the same effect without needing to create it from scratch. When you hover over a preset, a menu icon appears. And if you click on it, you'll see options to rename the preset or delete it. You can also export the preset to save it to your computer, or if you have multiple presets, you can choose Export All Custom Presets to save them as a set. I'll choose Export Preset. Then choose where you want to save it. I'll save mine to a folder on my desktop. You can rename the preset if you need to, or just click Save. To remove a preset from your image, just drag its layer group down onto the trash bin. And to show you how to import a preset, I'll delete the preset itself by clicking the menu icon and choosing Delete Preset. And I'll click Delete again to confirm it. To import a preset, click the Adjustments panel menu icon and choose Import Presets. Then navigate to where you saved the preset, click on it to select it, and click Open. The preset reappears under Your Presets and you can click on it to apply it. And there we have it. That's how to save your own adjustment layer presets in the latest version of Photoshop. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.